Let's begin with our one-on-one interview with George Papadopoulos' fiancee. First, a quick reminder of who Papadopoulos is and the role he plays in this Russia investigation. Papadopoulos joined the Trump campaign as a foreign policy advisor in early March 2016, soon after then-candidate Trump first referenced him as an advisor. On March 31st, Papadopoulos attended a Trump campaign foreign policy meeting. Trump was there, as well as then-Senator Jeff Sessions. During this sit-down, Papadopoulos said he had connections that could help set up a meeting between Trump and Russian President Vladimir Putin. Sources inside the meeting say Trump was open to the idea, but Sessions threw cold water onto the pitch. Roughly a month later, in April, Papadopoulos met with an overseas professor who told him that Russia had, quote, dirt on Hillary Clinton in the form of thousands of emails. During this period, Papadopoulos continued emailing Trump campaign members, pushing for a meeting between Trump and Russian officials. Fast forward to this year, when Papadopoulos is arrested for lying to FBI agents about his Russian contacts. His indictment was unsealed in October. It revealed that Papadopoulos was working with Robert Mueller, the special prosecutor. The White House immediately tried to distance itself and downplay his role.
Can you just explain what George Papadopoulos' role with the campaign was?
It was extremely limited. It was a volunteer position. And again, no activity was ever done in an official capacity. He reached out and nothing happened beyond that, which I think shows, one, his level of importance in the campaign, and two, shows what little role he had within coordinating anything officially for the campaign.
Papadopoulos' fiancée is pushing back today. Our justice correspondent, Pamela Brown, sat down with her. Pamela's with us right now. So what did she tell you, Pamela?
Well, this is the first time we're hearing George Papadopoulos' side of the story since the plea deal was released, and it's through his fiancée, Simona Magenta. She wanted to share things that Papadopoulos himself has not been able to discuss because, on the advice of his lawyers, he is not speaking publicly with the media as he awaits sentencing. His fiancée, an Italian national who says she, too, was interviewed by the FBI in relation to the Russia investigation, strongly refutes pushback against claims by White House and campaign officials that Papadopoulos only acted on his own without campaign approval, and he was nothing more than a coffee boy. What have you seen, what have you read that doesn't square with the George Papadopoulos you know?
George Papadopoulos has everything but a coffee boy. He's an outstanding personality, is very educated, articulated, and even his contribution to the campaign has been much more relevant than bringing coffee.
Why do you think the White House was so quick to come out and call him a coffee boy or a low-level volunteer?
I think they wanted to dissociate from the first person who decided to actively cooperate with the government on the right side. And probably the easiest way out is to dismiss his personality and lower him to a low-level volunteer.
And you don't believe he was?
I know he wasn't.
How do you know he wasn't?
He shared with me some details about his contribution to the campaign.
You say that he was consistently in touch with these high-level campaign officials.
Yes.
What was his interaction with Michael Flynn?
He was in contact with Michael Flynn, and he worked with Michael Flynn during the transition, and he was actively contributing to develop the foreign policy strategies for the campaign, and he didn't take any initiative on his own without campaign approval.
And Magenta says Papadopoulos communicated with Flynn, Steve Bannon, and former campaign advisor Rick Dearborn about topics other than Russia, but she says he interacted with other top campaign officials, including Corey Lewandowski, Paul Manafort, and Sam Clovis earlier in the campaign about setting up Russia meetings. They have all denied, downplayed, or say they don't recall ever interacting with Papadopoulos. She also says the campaign's deputy communications director, Brian Lanza, now CNN contributor, allowed him to do the only interview with the Russian news agency Interfax. He declined to comment. As Papadopoulos awaits his sentencing, she says she hopes President Trump will pardon him. Well, if the White House has not provided comment.